Hello, welcome to Drake Array Gaming. Today we're going to be talking about the top 5 overrated things for streaming and why you don't need to spend a lot of money to get top quality camera, lighting, microphone. Oh yeah. So as usual, no BS, no fluff. Here we go. All right, let's get started here. I always like to jump right into it. First topic we're going to talk about is microphones. So there's a lot of different options. It depends what your price range is. But if you want a nice, warm podcast style mic, something with background removal, you really don't have to spend a whole lot. One of our first options is the Razer Siren Mini. It's $49.99. And you can use a lot of different microphones around this price range and still get decent quality, especially if you have an NVIDIA graphics card. There's something called NVIDIA Broadcast that you can use. I actually have it installed here. And there's different voice filters out there as well, Crisp. There's also built-in filters into OBS/Streamlabs that you can use. The NVIDIA Broadcast filter, if you do, is built into all the RTX cards. You can actually get RTX Voice as well to work on GTX cards, but essentially you set your input device and you can adjust your strength volume on the noise filtering. You can make any mic sound good with that, as well as Crisp, as well as filters. Any decent mic, especially one with a built-in shock mounts like this one, you can get all the streaming type quality for around $50. And then if you want to go up from there, they got Razer Siren X, they got the HyperX microphones for around the $80 range, $100 range. And the classic Blue Yeti is a great microphone with great settings, especially if you're in different types of situations where you need to use different patterns for the microphone to pick up sound. A lot of streamers still use this. My personal favorite, I'm actually using the Elgato Wave 3 right now. I get $400 microphone sound out of a $140 mic. It has built-in anti-clipping, bunch of different technology. There's a lot of good microphones out there, and especially if you have an NVIDIA card, but really if you have an AMD graphics card, ATI card, you can get good sound using the Crisp filters, the OBS filters, and other noise canceling filters out there. But if you want that warm podcast style microphone, it really starts around the $140 range, $100 to $150 range, and you can get this nice quality sounding mic like I'm using right now. Microphones can be really overrated, especially if you're just looking for a decent mic to cut the noise background and all those kinds of things. You don't have to break the bank. $50 to $150, you're going to get great sound. Obviously, $50 you get decent sound. $150, you're going to get amazing sound at a $400 quality. Now, let's jump into the next item, camera. This is another highly overrated item. Great cameras look nice. A lot of streamers use DSLRs and all this other kind of stuff. You can get any webcam to look like a DSLR, especially with different settings, filters. You really don't need to break the bank on a camera. These are the classic Logitech C920, C930E, C922X. You're looking at a C922X. I also use a C930. The C930, believe it or not, actually has one of the better cameras as far as clarity and things like that. So you can get a C930 for $88, $60, sometimes $60. Anywhere from $60 to $80, you can get one of these cameras. But honestly, any 30 to 60 FPS 1080p camera is going to do great, and you can get it for like $40 to $60. But if you want to get a C920, they're $60, $78. I mean, they even have the C960. I mean, it's $31.99. You get 1080p, two mics, 90 degree view. It's plug and play, conferencing certified. You really don't have to break the bank on it. That's what I'm using. If you have decent lighting, decent microphone, you can dial in the camera and get really decent settings as well, especially with just adjusting some of the actual camera settings itself in Streamlabs. So you're looking at one of these cheapy cameras right now. You're hearing an Elgato Wave 3 right now. We're looking at $200 for my webcam, my microphone, etc. So you doesn't have to break the bank. Let's look at another overrated item, the chair. This is a Respawn chair. It has a back support and a neck support. I never used the neck support really, but you do want to get like maybe a chair that's height adjustable and has some tilt, decent chair. Comfort is definitely important, but you're looking at these pads because you don't have to break the bank for comfort. This chair wasn't that much, and I actually use one of these Extreme Comforts fatigue pads. And they're amazing. They breathe really well. I read on this cushion, and a lot of women that were pregnant, people that sit a lot at work, you can read the reviews on a lot of these fatigue pads, and some of the chairs just don't come with the comfort you need to sit for a long time, and you don't need to buy orthopedic $700 chair, $500 chair, $300 chair. I think this chair was $199 or $160. The Respawn has a really good value on the chairs, and you can actually just get a fatigue pad for it, which don't run a whole lot, anywhere from $25 to whatever. I even use a back pad too that helps a lot. And you can get these at like Ross or Marshall's for like $12. You can order them on Amazon for $20, for $30. So one of my brands that I really like is the Extreme Comfort ones. So like this is another example of one, and it has a cutout. You can get them solid like the one I have, but they're $30 and they breathe really well. So you don't really have to break the bank on a gaming chair too, to, you know, there's money to be saved that you can use in your hardware or other places. So definitely somewhere you don't have to spend a ton of money. Another item you don't have to spend a ton of money on is the lighting. You can act, what you want is a LED dimmable ring light or box light. The basics, $17, $18, you can get, you know, for $20 shipping, whatever, tax, you can get an adjustable ring light with a control unit on it, and dial in your lighting. If you need a ton of lighting, I would recommend going higher than that. You know, for $70, you can get a full-blown box light kit. Now, mind you, these are not adjustable. I actually use two box lights and one ring light overhead that is adjustable, but for $70, you can get a whole kit. For $20, you can get an actual adjustable ring light with three different warmths. What I recommend if you do have the money, I actually am running and they have a great deal right now on Amazon, a newer ring, 18-inch, fully adjustable, 5500K ring light for portrait shooting, etc. I mean, you can really dial in the settings. You get the tripod, it's fully adjustable and dimmable. It's a really great light, and they have a model above that's even better. But for like $68, you can get an amazing light. But again, you don't have to break the bank. You can even get on eBay, get a box, like single box light for like $30 with a 600 watt bulb. These have some newer 85 watt more economic bulbs, but you don't have to break the bank. You really don't have to break the bank, but you want something dimmable so you can dial in the lighting and get good lighting, so you can dial in the camera and dial in the microphone. It's really about spending your money wisely for your situation and utilizing the settings to dial it all in and use it together, and you can get a great setup for not breaking the bank. Let's go ahead and move on to the next item. I'm actually using like a $17 boom mic, and you can see it does the job. It does what I need it to do. This is just a cheap mic. Actually, it's like $14 right now. I think I pay like $17 for mine. Comes with the adapter, comes with a microphone holder, different things. So these are definitely on the cheaper side, but they work great. And you don't have to break the bank on them. You can also get them in kits with a bunch of different pop filters, adjustable things, straps, shock mounts, whatever you're going to need for your setup. This is like $23. For $33, you can get even a higher quality shock mount, adapters, pop filters, cables, kit. You know, you can get the full shebang with it. And if you have a little bit more money, instead of spending $100, $200 on a Rode boom mic, you can get the same quality kind of Rode professional boom overhead mic, springless one with the internal little adjustable kind of rockers on it, for $50. And you really don't have to break the bank on the boom mic, the camera, the lighting, the seat, the chair, anything like that. You can get everything you need for a good cost, put more hardware into your PC, you know, put the money into your PC for hardware, etc., without breaking the bank. A bonus item too, I use green screen obviously, so I just wanted to throw this in as another bonus item on what you don't have to break the bank on, but cotton wrinkle free green screens. You don't have to spend a bunch with the expandable ones or anything like that are $150. If you have a tight space, these ones that actually fit on your chair, they're like $35, and those work as well. I don't like it because they're not big enough. What I would recommend is actually going with like a cotton chroma key green screen. You can get a 6x9 for $20, 5x7 for $14. And a lot of them actually do come, with a stand. So you can get this 5x7 green screen with the stand, with the bag, with clamps, everything ready to go for like $38. I believe $25 as well. This one might actually come with one of the stands. And this is what I'm talking about. So you can actually clamp it up, stand it. It's bigger, it's better. And you really don't have to break the bank. You know, you can throw it in your dryer on high heat and get it wrinkle-free and hang it directly after, and the gravity and everything, just go ahead, you know, and just, you know, I even when I didn't have a stand and I was really cheaping it out, I bought a green screen for $10 and I, you know, just used some thumbtacks and I tacked it to the wall or the ceiling. You know, you do whatever you have to do to get the quality you need, but you don't have to break the bank. I hope this helped you guys out. I use a lot of these items still to this day. As you gain money or maybe some tips through your streams or you're setting up to do videos, you know, you can get that money and you can upgrade as you go. You really don't have to spend a lot to break the bank. I hope this information helped you guys out. Please remember, like, comment, subscribe. I love to comment down below. Check out my live streams on Thursday and Saturday, and I'll see you next time.